Okay, so good afternoon, everybody. It's a great pleasure to have all of you here for this wonderful ceremony of the Ramanujan Prize, awarding the Ramanujan Prize for the year 2022, which is a result of a very beautiful collaboration between the Department of Science, Technology, ICTP, and in the International Mathematical Union. Let me begin by welcoming our distinguished guests who are here. Professor Ulrike Tillmann, she's the Vice President of the International Mathematical Union, one of our partners in this prize. An important delegation from Senegal, I'm very happy to welcome them here. They have taken the time to visit us at ICTP, led by His Excellency Dr. Papa Abdoulaye Seck, Ambassador of Senegal to Italy. Professor Mamadou Sy, Director of Strategies and Planning of Research, who is also a former ICTP associate. And Professor Diaraf Seck, Technical Counselor at the Ministry, and a friend of ICTP who has collaborated on many scientific activities. So we are very happy to have this very distinguished people visiting at ICTP. And I'm pleased that this year's Ramanujan Prize is awarded to Professor Mouhamed Moustapha Fall. This is the first time a Senegalese scientist receives this prestigious award, and I'm happy that his family is here too. So far, we've had four awardees from India, four from Brazil, four from China, two from Argentina, one from Vietnam, one from Gabon, and one from Mexico. This 2022 Ramanujan Prize Selection Committee had many eminent mathematicians on the selection panel. Professor G. Rangarajan from the Indian Institute of Science, Bengaluru in India. Professor Toro from University of Washington and MSRI Berkeley in the US. Professor Nang from École Normale Supérieure, Libreville in Gabon. Professor Aïssa Wad, Penn State University, who is also a member of ICTP Scientific Council, and Professor Lothar Goetsche, who chaired this committee, and he is a mathematician professor at ICTP. And the prize citation I will read reads as follows. The prize is in recognition for his impressive results on existence and non-existence of solutions of linear and non-linear partial differential equations, inspired by geometry and mathematical physics, especially for his remarkable study of solutions to fractional Schrodinger equations and non-local mean curvature problems. The committee also recognizes his outstanding contributions to the advancement of mathematics in Africa through research and public engagement. The prize is the result of, as I said, is a collaboration between ICTP, DST, and IMU, and we hope that this collaboration will continue for a long time. I would like to specially thank the Department of Science and Technology and Government of India for their generous support for the Ramanujan Prize every year. Moustapha is the president of the African Institute for Mathematical Sciences and has an endowed chair of mathematics and its application at AIMS-Senegal, African Institute for Mathematical Sciences. He has an old and important connection at ICTP. He was a diploma student in maths for the academic year 2004-2005, and then was also an ICTP associate. I would like to take this opportunity also to thank the Simons Foundation, who awarded Dr. Fall the ICTP Simons Associateship in 2014, a prestigious fellowship which allows for extended visits for conducting mathematical research, both for Dr. Fall and his students. So congratulations once again to Moustapha. And today is a special day for ICTP and for Senegal because the president of Senegal himself, His Excellency Dr. Macky Sall, decided to send his greetings, personal greetings, in a video recorded messages. So this is also I think congratulations again to Moustapha. And so we will start with the video recorded messages from the President of Senegal, His Excellency Dr. Sall. Thank you.
Je suis heureux de me joindre à vous à l'occasion de la cérémonie de remise du prix Ramanujan 2022 dédiée aux jeunes mathématiciens des pays en développement. Je félicite chaleureusement M. Attis Tabor-Kar, directeur du Centre international pour la physique théorique, pour cette excellente initiative qui fête bientôt ses 20 ans. Le Sénégal est honoré de voir cette prestigieuse distinction décernée à notre compatriote Dr. Mouhamed Moustapha Fall, président de l'Institut africain des sciences mathématiques. J'en suis d'autant plus fier que M. Fall est un pur produit de l'école sénégalaise où il a obtenu son diplôme d'études approfondies en mathématiques avant de fréquenter le Centre international de physique théorique et de faire sa thèse à l'International School for Advanced Studies. Sa fonction actuelle de président de l'Institut africain des sciences mathématiques de Mbour, que notre pays abrite et soutient depuis 2011, est une belle étape d'une carrière que je lui souhaite longue et réussie. Je renouvelle toutes mes félicitations à notre distingué lauréat et lui redis ma fierté est celle de la nation sénégalaise. Sa performance confirme la pertinence du choix que nous avons fait de promouvoir davantage l'enseignement des disciplines scientifiques et technologiques dans notre système éducatif, notamment par la création de lycées d'excellence, l'ouverture de classes préparatoires aux grandes écoles, la modernisation des laboratoires de nos universités et instituts supérieurs et le prix Macky Sall pour la recherche scientifique et technique du CAMES, qui est le Conseil africain et malgache pour l'enseignement supérieur. Dans l'histoire des sociétés humaines, la science, la technologie et l'innovation ont toujours porté le progrès pour le bien-être économique et social des peuples. C'est pourquoi je tiens à rendre un hommage appuyé aux efforts que déploie votre centre pour créer l'émulation entre les jeunes mathématiciens des pays en développement en distinguant les meilleurs parmi eux. Tous mes voeux de succès vous accompagnent.
So it is my pleasure now to ask our partners to give welcome remarks. So we're expecting some from the DST, but apparently there is a problem in connecting. So I will pass the floor first to the Ambassador of India to Italy. Her Excellency Dr. Nina Malhotra sent us a message for congratulating and for being with us today. So.
Honorable Secretary, Department of Science and Technology, Government of India, Director of the Abdus Salam International Center for Theoretical Physics, Shri Atish Dabolkar, President of the International Mathematical Union, Carlos Kenning, professors, faculty members, researchers, and practitioners of mathematics. I'm delighted to join you all today. This year, this event is taking place in the backdrop of many significant developments in India-Italy relationship. We recently had an immensely successful visit of PM Giorgia Meloni to India. Our two countries are also celebrating the 75th anniversary of the establishment of diplomatic relations this year, and India is holding the G20 presidency. I extend my heartfelt congratulations to Professor Moustapha Fall, Professor and President of the African Institute for Mathematical Sciences in Senegal, for being awarded the prestigious Ramanujan Prize for the year 2022. The award is a recognition of his outstanding work and contribution in the theory of partial differential equations and also reflects your important organizational role in advancement of mathematics in your country. I'm sure that this well-deserved award will motivate you further to expand your research and inspire other researchers and young mathematicians, not only in your country, but in the entire developing world. I feel proud in stating that this award not only showcases India's historic contribution to the field of mathematics, but also highlights and perpetuates the legacy of Srinivas Ramanujan, a brilliant Indian mathematician. I'm intrigued by the fact that the wealth of ideas he created a century ago are being researched upon and finding applications in diverse contexts till today. I would like to take this opportunity to thank ICTP Italy, IMU Germany and DST India for their contribution to the legacy of the great Ramanujan. I wish all the very best to the event and look forward to mutually enriching association in future. Thank you.
Thank again Her Excellency for being with us and sending her message. I would like now to give the floor to Professor Ulrike Tillmann. Professor Tillmann, she is actually a fellow of the Royal Society and chairman of one of the most important institutes in mathematics in the world. So she is the director of the Isaac Newton Institute for Mathematical Sciences. And but today she's here also in her capacity as vice president of the International Mathematical Union, which is of course a crucial partner in this initiative of the Ramanujan Prize. So I'm happy to leave Professor Tillmann the floor.
Thank you very much. It's a pleasure to be here. Let me just say something about mathematics itself. The physicist Wigner famously commented on the unreasonable effectiveness of mathematics when 60 years ago he received the Nobel Prize. His discovery and application of fundamental symmetries principles, in other words, group theory, led to his groundbreaking contributions in particle physics. He also points out at the same time another mathematical theory, the theory of complex Hilbert spaces, which in turn became fundamental to the formulation of quantum mechanics and nowadays quantum information. Physics is not the only area of application where mathematics has proven to be essential. Modern cryptography, think public key encryption, is based on number theory, the very subject that Ramanujan studied and that his mentor, G.H. Hardy, claimed to have no practical use whatsoever in his famous essay, A Mathematician's Apology. The power of mathematical abstraction is indeed unreasonable. To give just one concrete example, in the work of an Oxford colleague, the same mathematical analysis used to design dust filters in vacuum cleaners has been used to develop filters to remove arsenic from groundwaters in the Ganges Delta, impacting hundreds of thousands of people and saving lives. In the opening ceremony of the 2002 International Congress of Mathematics in the Great Hall of People, in the presence of the then President Zhao Zemin, a doubling of the financial investment into mathematics was announced to accelerate the development of science and technology. 20 years later, the success of the Chinese strategy is evident. As mathematics is underlying nearly all of science and technology, it may not be so easy to quantify the effect of this investment. But let me just quote a study by the global consulting company Deloitte, just as a proxy. It estimated the impact of mathematics on the UK economy as more than 15% of GDP. So mathematics, interpreted in the broadest way, provides a cost-effective, because we don't need big laboratories, and hence democratic route into high tech and prosperity for many countries. The investment in teaching and research mathematics is in particular an investment in people. It is enabling, it is giving people the power to think and the tools and confidence to attack the most taxing problems, whatever shape. I'm very honored to represent the International Mathematical Union here today as we celebrate the achievements of one of the world's brightest mathematical minds. The IMU was founded in 1920 at the inaugural International Congress of Mathematicians held in Strasbourg, France. It was created to promote international cooperation in mathematics and to support the development of mathematical research and education worldwide. Over the past 100 years, the IMU has indeed played a vital role in advancing mathematics, not least through its very active Commission for Developing Countries. Most visibly, it organizes every 4 years the International Congress of Mathematicians, its flagship event. The next ICM will be in the US, but earlier this century, it has been held in Brazil and in India, and I very much hope that it will soon also be possible to hold an ICM in Africa. Today, we have every reason to be hopeful for the future of mathematics in Africa, and I just want to extend my warmest congratulations to Mouhamed and his family.
Thanks a lot. And I would like to ask His Excellency Dr. Papa Abdoulaye Yessek, Ambassador of Senegal to Italy, to join us in welcoming this award.
Monsieur le Directeur de l'Institut International pour la physique théorique, distingués participants, mesdames, messieurs. Cet après-midi, incontestablement, je m'acquitte d'un agréable devoir en représentant Son Excellence le professeur Moussa Baldé, ministre de l'Enseignement supérieur, de la Recherche et de l'Innovation du gouvernement de la République du Sénégal. Son Excellence, le professeur Moussa Baldé, avait bien voulu être parmi nous, mais il est retenu à Dakar pour des obligations gouvernementales. Il m'a demandé de vous transmettre ses vifs regrets de ne pas être aujourd'hui parmi nous. Chers amis, il y a une forte corrélation entre la promotion de la recherche scientifique d'un pays et son niveau de développement socio-économique. C'est pourquoi le gouvernement du Sénégal considère qu'une recherche forte, générant des connaissances et des technologies en harmonie avec nos aspirations les plus profondes, constitue, sans nul doute, une condition sine qua non pour assurer notre émergence socio-économique. C'est pourquoi cette volonté est illustrée, le président de la République l'a dit tantôt, par l'instauration d'un prix président Macky Sall pour la recherche, un vaste programme de modernisation de nos laboratoires. Le Sénégal compte aujourd'hui le supercalculateur le plus performant dans notre espace, ce qui est absolument remarquable parce que pour ceux qui font de la recherche, pour avoir de bonnes précisions, il faut véritablement un outil tel qu'un supercalculateur. Il y a aussi la création de lycées scientifiques, le président en a parlé, un centre d'excellence en mathématiques, informatique, éthique, mais aussi de nouvelles universités pour diversifier l'offre de formation en vue d'assurer l'adéquation formation-emploi. En réalité, le gouvernement du Sénégal a fait une option claire. Il s'agit d'une densification, d'une fortification et d'une massification de notre dispositif de recherche et d'enseignement. C'est précisément cela qui va permettre de créer les conditions idoines de ce qu'on pourrait appeler une expression plurielle de l'excellence, expression plurielle de l'excellence consistant à libérer le génie potentiel et créateur des Sénégalais et des Sénégalaises. Car en réalité, le progrès n'est pas le fait du hasard. Progresser, c'est faire les choses autrement et mieux, avec comme adjuvant l'innovation technologique, que d'aucuns considèrent comme la première des matières premières pour doper nos économies. Alors, fort de tout cela, le gouvernement du Sénégal, par ma voix, s'honore et se réjouit, simplement, mais profondément, de cette haute distinction décernée au professeur Mouhamed Moustapha Fall, pur produit de l'école sénégalaise, comme l'a dit le président de la République, un jeune et brillant mathématicien, profondément attaché à l'excellence en tout lieu, en tout temps et en tout lieu. Professeur Fall dirige présentement avec brio l'Institut africain des sciences mathématiques. Nous sommes sûrs et convaincus, professeur, que ce prix ne va pas être la borne supérieure de vos performances. Professeur Fall va incontestablement se bonifier et contribuer davantage à la domestication des mathématiques. Et oui, la domestication des mathématiques est un enjeu planétaire. Plus de mathématiques, plus de développement. Donc, il faut bien que nous domestiquions les mathématiques pour qu'elles soient l'affaire de tous. Professeur Fall, notre fierté est infinie. Mais nos attentes vous concernant sont aussi immenses. Parce qu'on attend toujours plus de cerveaux supérieurs, car le monde est gouverné par la connaissance. Je voudrais tout naturellement associer à mes félicitations votre père, l'honorable Khalil Ibrahim Fall, éminent député de l'Assemblée nationale du Sénégal, éminent opérateur économique, un homme de développement qui a beaucoup contribué et qui contribue encore pour un Sénégal debout, prospère, aux dividendes partagés. Grande a été ma joie d'apprendre que vous êtes le père de l'homme que nous célébrons aujourd'hui. Associez aussi à mes félicitations votre épouse, qui est aussi mathématicienne, m'a-t-on dit. Comme quoi, en apprenant les mathématiques, ça n'a pas encore mené aux mathématiques. Félicitez aussi toute la communauté scientifique nationale, parce qu'il est un produit de vous. Il est un de vos produits. Nous sommes vraiment fiers. Fiers parce que on a l'habitude de dire que les mathématiques sont inaccessibles, que c'est extrêmement compliqué. Mais avoir un jeune neveu professeur d'université qui vient d'être primé constitue l'antithèse de cette assertion. Les mathématiques doivent être étudiés par tous. Puisqu'il faut, et on m'a dit qu'il s'agit d'un mot, pour éviter de faire de ce mot une phrase, je dois peut-être conclure. En remerciant et en félicitant le professeur Attis, directeur du Centre international pour la physique théorique. Vous nous avez tantôt fait une présentation qui montre que ce centre est un centre d'excellence, qu'il peut contribuer conséquemment au renforcement et à l'élargissement des acquis scientifiques dans nos espaces grâce à ce qu'on pourrait appeler une parcellisation des responsabilités assortie d'une agrégation des compétences pour mieux comprendre le monde en vue de mieux l'expliquer. Bravo pour le travail que vous faites. Associer, remercier et féliciter aussi le gouvernement indien. Il ne faut jamais oublier ceux qui en font plus. Remercier et féliciter enfin tous ceux qui œuvrent et luttent inlassablement pour un monde meilleur, un monde de paix, un monde de progrès durable et continu et un monde de justice sociale. Et la science peut être un intrant stratégique majeur dans le cadre de la construction de ce monde nouveau. Je vous remercie de votre aimable attention.
Thank you very much, His Excellency. Now, since it's always good to practice our French, but just to help us, no, we should actually, we should definitely improve on that side, but fortunately we have our colleague Corinne, she will read a translation in English.
Okay, so His Excellency allowed me to sort of make a short summary of what he just said. So he first of all sort of presented the regrets of the Minister of Education that really wanted to be with us but was unfortunately unable to attend today, but he sends his warm congratulations and thanks to ICTP and to the Government of India and the Association of International Mathematic Union for that prize and for sort of rewarding Professor Fal. He reinforced in his address, actually, the importance of what the President of Senegal just presented in his talk, which was research and education is really key for the development of any country, and particularly in Senegal, and that Senegal embarked in really investing in excellence in research and education, starting at the level of the lycée, which is this sort of when you are about 18, up to building new universities and new tools for research, like the calculator, if I'm not mistaken. You translate calculator by calculator, probably. He really sort of emphasized the fact that this is really very important for any nation in its growth to learn mathematics, although it might be from a very first acquaintance with mathematics, it looks difficult and maybe not the kind of discipline that you would envisage or embrace, but it's really important to encourage young people and through the example of Professor Fine to and his success to sort of path the way. And he associated, I wanted to sort of thank and congratulate Professor Spall, of course, his family, his father, who is really a renowned and very important figure in Senegal, his wife as well, and we know that wives are very important for the career, behind the scene careers, and that's my personal touch, sorry, that's not His Excellency. And in conclusion, he wanted to congratulate Professor Attish Dabolkar, the center of ICTP, that for its mission since the very beginning, which is really making a better world through science. And he thanks you all, and I hope I was not mistaken in sort of translating what you had in mind. Thank you so much. Thank you.
So now we open a kind of a second part of today's ceremony. And now I think we are all quite curious to understand a bit better some of the contribution of Mouhamed Moustapha Fall to mathematics. I myself had to study some of Moustapha's works, and he's definitely one of the great experts in partial differential equations, but with an eye to applications to also to geometric problems. And for example, his kind of non-local Alexandrov theorem, I think it's one of the beauty of the past few years in the crossroad of analysis and geometry, actually something for which he has already received important honors around the world. I mean, just to mention one, he has been invited speaker at the International Congress in 2018. So in order to understand a bit more about Fall's work, we have asked one of the greatest experts in analysis to help us. Unfortunately, he had to leave a bit before, but he managed to leave a message explaining to us mathematically Paul's work. I think it should appear. But so Professor Luigi Ambrosio from the Scuola Normale Superiore has given this short presentation of Fall's work.
Good morning. First of all, let me congratulate with Professor Fall for this important achievement, for this recognition for his work. This is an important prize associated to the name of an outstanding mathematician. And it is also sponsored by important institution, the ICTP, the International Mathematical Union, the Department of Science and Technology of the Indian government. And so congratulations. And it is a real pleasure for me to have this occasion to outline in a few minutes the career and the scientific production of Professor Fall. So let me start to share the screen. Okay. Professor Fall is presently professor of mathematics at the African Institute for Mathematical Sciences in Senegal, and also president of the institute. His career has been fast. After his bachelor studies in his country, he came to ICTP, where he got the diploma in 2005. And immediately after, he got a PhD position at CISA, where he got the PhD thesis under the supervision of my colleague Andrea Malchiodi in 2009. Then he had several postdoc positions, which also were important to establish contacts, which scientific contacts, which are still going on now. And his professor now has been had also a professor position at ICTP for 4 years. Among his main achievements, I would like to stress in particular the one, the invitation as a speaker at the ICM in Rio de Janeiro. And by the way, it is evident for his CV, his capacity also to train young students in mathematics. He had already several PhD students, and also his important engagement in the development of mathematics in his country and in Africa. What are the topics covered by Professor Fall in his career so far? Let me say that eventually I have chosen, since my time is limited, to spend more words about two papers, which I consider particularly striking and interesting. But he started his scientific work at the time of the PhD thesis in CISA on the theory of isoperimetric sets with a small volume. So trying to analyze the asymptotic behavior of surfaces with a large mean curvature associated also to variational problems with a small volume constraint. Then he also studied several hard type problems, meaning problems where a singularity appears either inside the domain, let's say at the origin or on the boundary of the domain. He studied problems dealing with the bifurcation or expansions of eigenvalues, in particular Neumann eigenvalues. And I would say the main research interest of him in the last few years has been the theory of fractional differential operators. So this is actually the topic of the two papers I will tell you later on. All these things, of course, with the variety of tools coming from functional analysis, Hilbert manifolds, of course, the many tools from partial differential equations, and in particular, I would like to stress Morse theory and harmonic analysis. To go on, let me start indeed from this paper. I want to tell you something about this paper published in this important journal more or less 10 years ago. This paper was written with Enrico Valtinoci and this with this semilinear fractional PDE, where of course the semilinearity comes from this nonlinearity in the right-hand side, and the fractional character comes from the fact that we are considering here the alpha power of minus the Laplacian with alpha strictly less than one. As you many of you know, the left-hand side in this PDE, let's say the linear part, is naturally associated with this Sobolev norm, which consists of the Gagliardo semi-norm, which is basically, at least formally, the L2 norm of the alpha fractional derivative. And this is only a semi-norm. By adding, for instance, the L2 norm, we turn it into a norm which defines a Sobolev space and a fractional Sobolev space. The exponent p in the nonlinearity stays between 1 and 2 alpha star minus 1, where in this fractional theory, 2 alpha star plays the role of the classical Sobolev embedding theorem. Indeed, you see that for alpha equal 1, you recover 2n over n minus 2, which is the exponent of the classical theory. And this is associated to this Sobolev embedding. So what is the relation between this embedding and our PDE? Well, it comes from the fact that this PDE can also be attacked with variational methods by looking at the best constant C in this inequality. And because P plus 1 is smaller than 2 star, alpha star, there is enough compactness to gain ground states. And so the infimum in this kind of Rayleigh quotient provides to you the inverse of the best constant in this inequality. And the connection with the PDE star comes from the fact that if you consider a ground state normalized on the unit sphere of the LP plus 1 norm, then the Euler Lagrange equation appears and displays the role of a Lagrange multiplier. And by scaling, since this side is linear, this side is not linear because P is larger than 1, by scaling, you can recover by multiplying by a positive and independent of x constant, you can recover a solution to problem star. And it is well known that, of course, variational solutions have special properties. And one of the main results of this paper is obtained by a kind of perturbative analysis by analyzing the linearized operator and suite of branches of eigenvalues. In this paper, Valdinoci and Professor Fall have been able to prove that for alpha sufficiently close to one, uniqueness of the ground state persists, and also the symmetrization gives you that it is radial. This paper generated quite some interest. Indeed, shortly later, in a paper which appeared on ACTA, Frank, Lenzmann, and Silvestre were able to extend this result to all ranges of alpha between 0 and 1. The second paper I want to tell you, somehow related, is a paper appeared on Krell in 2018. And to put this paper into context, let me remind that in 2010, in a seminal paper, Caffarelli, Roque Joffre, and Savenne introduced the notion of a fractional perimeter. Actually, here P should depend on alpha, so the P alpha perimeter, which, as you see, takes into account the interaction between points inside and points outside the domain, weighted by this singular kernel. And this paper initiated a study of the regularity of minimizers, really along the lines of the classical theory, meaning you may try to understand the structure of cones, of vector solutions, the dimension of the singular set, and so on. And most results, but not all of them, have a perturbative nature, meaning that if you know that some property is true for classical surfaces, minimal surfaces, then by a perturbative analysis, you can try to show that they persist. Also, like indeed in the previous paper I mentioned to you, for alpha sufficiently close to one. This is also justified by the fact that if in this formula you multiply P by a constant, by a factor proportional to 1 minus alpha, indeed one can show that the alpha perimeter converges, more precisely gamma converges, to the classical perimeter. But what is even more important is that, as in the classical theory, a fractional notion of mean curvature emerged for local minimizing and even stationary solutions. You can write it as a principal value, and also maybe by an integration by parts, if E is sufficiently smooth, you can write it as a term, as a boundary integral, which in some sense makes more clear the geometric character of this expression, which is the so-called fractional mean curvature. And then, again, we can try to follow the analogy with the classical theory. And what Cabré, Sole Morales, and Bett, together with Fall, they were been able in this paper to obtain one of the first classification or rigidity results for constant fractional mean curvature surfaces, extending a classical theorem for the classical mean curvature surfaces due to the Russian mathematician Alexandrov. Precisely, the result is this, that if E is a bounded open set with a sufficiently regular boundary, sufficiently regular with respect to the parameter alpha, which appears in the fractional perimeter, under this assumption, if the mean curvature H is constant on the boundary, then E modulo negligible set must be a ball. So this is a rigidity result, which actually then can be generalized also in several other ways, using viscosity notions of mean curvature, relaxing, and also the regularity assumption. But this has really been one of the first results for fractional, constant fractional mean curvature of the theory. So I hope that this short presentation will has given to you a glimpse of the range of activity of Professor Fall, and let me congratulate with him again. Thank you for the attention.
Thanks, thanks a lot to Professor Ambrosio for being with us and explaining to us some of the beauty of Fall's work. So I think now we are all convinced, and now I think it's time that Fall finally receives this prize. We have been talking enough. So I think I invite Professor Tillman and Atish Dalbokar to pass the award to Professor Fall. I think you can go in front here. I mean, just to comment what's going on, the prize consists of a statue of Ramanujan, a certificate, and a cash prize supported by the government of India. The statue, the certificate, and the check. Now we ask you to give us a talk about to explain to us some of your work. And I think okay, you will come from. Yes.
Go forward, backwards, and okay. Keep press this for the pointer.
Okay.
Would you like to do this or
yes.
Do this?
Oh. No, it's okay. It's up to you. I can use this one.
Okay.
So thank you very much, Claudio. So, of course, it is a great honor to be here. So I didn't really prepare a speech because I know this place so much. I spend so much time and so many years in this place here that so it's very hard for me to write a speech and express all that I have in my heart. So I start, Professor Atish Dabholkar, so the International Center for Theoretical Physics Director. Professor Eric Tillman, Vice President of the International Mathematical Union. His Excellency Dr. Papa Abdoulaye Seck, Ambassador of Senegal, and the delegation sent by the Minister of Higher Education and Research in Senegal. I thank also Professor Ambrosio for his great presentation. So it is a great honor, of course, to be here, and I would like to start really to thank His Excellency President Macky Sall for his constant support the promotion of science in Senegal. His testimony, his video shows that, in fact, he's quite active and strong supporter of mathematics and, in general, science in Senegal. My greetings also go to the Minister of Higher Education and Research, who really wanted to be here. I know really well that, who could not. So I have also many people to thank. So I start first with my family, because without whom I would not be here, in particular my father, my mother, and our big family. So we have really, really have, yeah, so my wife also, who is here, supporting me day and night. So research is very jealous, as you all know. My research collaborators who are not here, and except one, Professor Muzina, who is here, who taught me hard inequalities. This is one of also the research field I studied, and the one that Professor Ambrosio was mentioning. My teachers. When I am talking about my teachers, it's not only those from Senegal, but also those from ICTP. Here and almost everywhere. So, and also very big family. So, which is also AIMS, so the African Institute for Mathematical Sciences, which is a big family, founded by Professor Neil Turok, and which provides one of the best places in Africa to do research. And in fact, there are even some alumni who are here. You see them here. Yeah, so yeah, so this is just to say that we are in fact trying our best to train. So I would not say the young scientists, because I think I'm in the young scientists because of the prize, but to train so the young, so young Africans also to be part of the future, I would say. So, it is, of course, an honor to receive this prize because it's, I would say, of course, a kind of marriage, because Ramanujan is a number theorist and my wife is a number theorist. So, at he was an autodidact person, which, of course, I was not, well, unfortunately or fortunately, because it's because of that probably I was here in ICTP, so where I really met great people, great scientists, who really make a big change in my research career. In fact, when I left the University Gaston Berger of Saint Louis in Senegal. So I left there as an applied mathematician. And when I came here, I met new people. I meet new people who are specialized in different fields and very great teachers. And it's from there that I decided to study geometric analysis. So it's not in general common. I think people in general, they start with pure mathematics and go to applied math, but I did the opposite. But I didn't regret it, because at least I can train people who are doing applied science. So thank you very much. I hope I didn't forget anyone. Ah, it was almost a mistake. I really want also to thank not only the director of ICTP, but also those people who are really working in ICTP, who also made our stay when we were here very young, almost 10 years ago, to come for the first time in Europe. So for some people, it's nothing, but for us, it was not that easy. To come for the first time. So the first time I left Senegal in 2004, I arrived here in Europe. It was quite cold, a cold that I never knew before. In fact, I didn't even know which type of clothing that I should wear to go to sport. It's something that I loved very much. But we really had many people in here in ICTP who was really also supporting us. So the support is not only science, but also in the social part. So thank you very much. And thank you very much also to CISA, where I did my PhD, Scuola Internazionale di Superiore Avanzati. So let me just start my presentation. It should be very quick, and I'm sorry because for those who really who are not mathematicians, so my father, I hope, you are going to discuss this later. So my talks will be about this type of problem, so overdetermined boundary value problems. So it is a subject that I start studying with my PhD student, who was from Cameroon. So he's now doing a postdoc in Frankfurt with my also collaborator, Tobias Wett. And so when he came to Senegal, so and he wanted to work with me, so I gave him this type of problems. And so since then, we found a lot of interest, and we keep working on this. And in particular, in the recent, since last year, so we decided to try to tackle one of the most difficult conjectures in this type of problems, which is known as the Schiffer conjecture. So this is around my presentation. So I'm going to show what is going on almost and exactly what we have on this subject. So there are many type of overdetermined problems coming from many different branch of mathematics. But so those that I really would like to talk about will be those which are elliptic type and of course driven by the Laplace operator, so the diffusion operator. So it is a very interesting field of research, so which of course appears also in fluid mechanics, in capillarity theory, in elasticity, and also in electrostatic problems. They appear also in shape optimization, so as many people know, so Professor Jarasek is an expert also in this type of shape optimization, so it's like Dirichlet problems and Neumann eigenvalues. So in general, so when you differentiate these eigenvalues, so you end up with an additional thing that comes on the eigenfunctions, and when you prescribe that, then you end up with an overdetermined problem. So they are also very interesting in as application, because in general, so whenever you solve this type of problems, then you have a solution also with explicit solutions to the stationary, also incompressible equations, of course, in the 2D case. So with some very good information on the pressure of the fluid on the boundary. So the problems, they look like this. They look quite simple, but still, there are many things that are going on, but it's very short equation. So you just say, so Laplacian of U equal a function, in an open set, and at the same time you want to prescribe two things at the same time. So you want to prescribe the value of the function and the value of the norm of the gradient. So, but in most papers, so you see people, they write the Neumann boundary condition, but the two are the same because U is constant at the boundary. So the problem is a free boundary problem because so what I am writing here is that we want to find a domain, we want to find a function U, we want to find functions F, so that something happened. So, and this thing that is happening is that you have to find all the solution, and therefore omega is part of the problems. And this makes, in fact, the problem is, difficult to solve. So in general, you don't even have solutions. You cannot use direct method of calculus of variation because you prescribe too many things. And therefore, in general, what people need to do is to construct solutions, construct the domain, construct the functions F in such a way that these things happen. Because as I said before, whenever you solve these type of problems, you have immediate applications in different fields in physics or so on. And so this is exactly what I said. So in general, so since these problems cannot be solved immediately, so if they have a solution, then that domain omega, which is a solution, has to be special. So, and so let me just give in the next two slides some few examples of where these type of problems they come and where they appear. So the most famous one is what is known as, sometimes people call it the Serrant's problem, or it is also sometimes call it the torsion problem, because they appear in also solid mechanics. And also, maybe if you look at only in the simplest problem, so where u of x is, of course, in general, so for probabilist in this equation, u of x is the first exit time of the Brownian motion in a domain omega. So in this clear situation, so u is proportional to the flow velocity of a viscous incompressible fluid moving in a parallel tube with cross-section that is named after omega. And the fact that omega is special is that whenever you have the omega, you are saying that you want to find a domain in such a way that the tangential stress of the fluid is constant along the pipe. And so as it was proved in 1971, that if, of course, omega is bounded and sufficiently smooth, then the only domain in which such type of fluids can have this property must be a ball. So there is another application, or maybe another problem that is very well studied also, is the case where you have the right-hand side is zero. So in this case, so you have an harmonic function, but of course in that you must ask also the domain to be unbounded, otherwise you don't have anything. And in this case, so u has this very beautiful shape. So I am saying here, R is the normalized Newton potential, because you need to normalize if the boundary of omega is unbounded. And in this case, also U is a single layer, so electric potential, so induced by when you charge the boundary of the domain by constant function, I would say. And here, the fact that omega is special would be that omega is such that so the electric field, so lambda u, is uniformly proportional to the integral of the normal. So the charge density is in equilibrium, in a sense. Such type of domains also are called exceptional domains and have strong connections also with the theory of minimal surfaces. We're going to see that later. But there is also some speciality, which is sometimes called rigidity, is that if the boundary of omega is compact, then so omega must be, again, so the boundary of omega must be a sphere. So in general, this problem one study in the exterior, so it's the exterior of a ball, so as was proved by Reichel, which was solving a conjecture by Gruber. So the most studied case is, so in general, this Dirichlet problem. So as I was saying, so in some cases, the problem is completely known due to an interesting argument of coming from geometry that was applied by Serrant in, which is the moving plane argument, in order to show that whenever you have such problems, and like F is beautiful enough, omega is bounded and smooth, then the domain must be a ball. And Weinberger also obtained also another interesting way to prove this, using only based on the maximum principle and using the P function, so kind of P function. So it looks like, when you look at the P function, it looks like, so the pressure, so when you want to transform this problem to solve the solution of the earlier equation. So there was also very big people also who studied this problem, so which is Beresteyn, Caffarelli, and Nirenberg in 1997, when omega is unbounded. And for certain types of domains, so they were able also to classify this type of domains, so using this argument that is also known as the sliding methods. But so the sliding method is not very far away from the moving plane method, but it is very convenient when you work also with unbounded domains. And also they made some interesting conjecture that maybe so when omega is unbounded, so the bound of omega is connected, so you must, so they propose that, you know, you must have certain specific shapes of the domain, which was disproved by Sigvaldi, who was able also to construct some undiluted surfaces, so when F is lambda U. So there are also several works that comes just later on, which are based on bifurcation argument, so which is due to Ross, Ruiz, and Sigvaldi, and other collaborators. So a new result, so that is obtained also by Ruiz. So Ruiz was usually here in ICTP, and the time that he was doing his postdoc here in CISA. So he also proved that, in fact, the positivity of U is important in the Serenz result, and it's very strange that this result was not known since the 1971. In fact, I really didn't know that. And so this is a recent paper. So in the case where F equals zero, so the paper that I was talking, so the argument, so the electrostatic problem that I was talking about in this case, so there is this work of Helen, Hoswitz, and Packard, so who were able in two dimensions also to prove that in fact there are domains which looks, the boundary of domains looks like catenoids, so in which you can have a solution to these problems. So this was so very interesting. So they were interested in more geometric problems, and so Treise, so in 2014, made a certain correspondence between the solutions, the boundary of the solution to this problem in two dimensions, and also the theory of minimal surfaces. So after that, so there are generalizations. So Liu, Wang, and Wei also obtained, you know, a high-dimensional result of this result of Helen, Hoswitz, and Packard, and with my collaborators, also we were able to find to prove also the existence of completely also new exceptional domains. We call it in a sense. So. We are talking about, so since I was talking about this, what I call the num, this Dirichlet problem, so the most, there is the most probably difficult, I would say, which still leave many open problems is, in fact, the Neumann problem. So let me just start, so with this long-standing conjecture, so which is named the after Schiffer, so one can see this conjecture. So in this kind of book of Yao, so the problem 80, so which states that so anytime you have a Neumann eigenfunction, so for which the function is constant on the boundary, so then omega has to be a ball. It's a very simple conjecture, but which is really open since many, many years. And so there are many people working on this, but there are very, very, very few results direction. So this problem is also linked with another very open problem, which is called so the Pompeii problem. So which states that so when you have the integral of a function, so which vanishes in a domain omega, which is bounded and connected, after changing the domains by rigid motion, then the function must be zero. So this is, of course, a very strange thing that these two problems are linked. But in fact, they are linked in a sense. Whenever so you have a domain omega, so with this property, so which satisfies the Pompeii problem, so the conjecture is false, and vice versa. And with a very interesting proof, probably that is based, probably I would say, on maybe complex analysis. So in a sense, there is a characterization of functions of domains that satisfy the Pompeii problem by looking at so the zero of the Fourier transform of the of the characteristic function of the domain. And once you have that, then you can link this property also with the Fourier transform of the shift of course, the shift of the solution to this Neumann problem. So U plus one will solve this, and then you can take the Fourier transform of this equation. It has a strong link between this and the Fourier transform of the zeros of the Fourier transform of the function. In fact, the proof is follow this type of ideas. There are a few results, I would say. Of course, there are many results in the Pompeii problem. Many people are working on this, but the problem is still open. And also the Schiffer conjecture is also, it's until now still open. But there are partial results. And the one that I probably would say would be probably the result of Bernstein, so in 1980, which states that if the problem, so for fixed domain omega, so you have infinitely many eigenvalues and infinitely many eigenfunctions, then the conjecture is a theorem. So there is also a result of Deng in 2012, so which extend a result of Aviles, which Aviles, in Italian it will be called Aviles, right? But in French it would be Avil, so, but I would say Aviles since I'm in Italy. So he also were able also to prove this conjecture, so for some small values of the parameter, so yeah. And in Riemannian manifolds also there are some results by Bernstein and Young, so I would say not on the sphere, but mainly on hyperbolic spaces, also which generalize the result of Bernstein and in higher dimensions. And there are also stability results, so that if the domain satisfies this problem and is very close to a ball, then in fact it is a ball. So which means this result, so one cannot expect a perturbation of the ball to show where to disprove the conjecture. So there was a paper by Sheklov, so who was really interested in these problems on different on manifolds, and he was able also to prove that in fact, so when you have certain domains, so with homogeneous boundary or isoparametric boundaries, then you can have, of course, solutions. So in a sense, for the simplicity, so if you are on a sphere, so if you take a spherical cup or an annulus, so you can build solutions to this conjecture, to this problem. So in a sense, you can have solutions which have these problems, but it's not. It has nothing to do with the conjecture, but just example of domains which support this problem. And so there was also his work of Swam, so who studied the problem on the two sphere. Sheklover's work was mainly in dimension on the sphere, but in sphere with dimension larger than three. So. And he also conjectured that only balls and annulus solve the Schiffer problem on the two sphere. So in a sense, it's likely so you can have only homogeneous domains or maybe annulus domains, maybe isoparametric domains, would solve the Schiffer problems on Riemannian manifolds. And in fact, so there is this generalized Schiffer problem, so on Riemannian manifold, that if you would have a solution to the Schiffer problem, is it true that the bound of omega is homogeneous or isoparametric? And so in a recent work, so we in fact disprove this conjecture. So this is just recent, so in 2003, that in fact this is not true. Which somehow disprove the Schiffer conjecture when you are on the flat cylinder and also when you are on the two sphere. And in this case, so we were able to prove that in fact the domain cannot be a geodesic ball and it cannot be also an annulus. So the idea is that in fact, so we use bifurcation argument, so which is here quite different from what people used to do in the Dirichlet problem. Because when we started with the initial perturbation, so we start with this annulus domain, we want to perturb, but however, it was probably very difficult to do what people used to do. So in a sense, if you want to find, to have new result, probably you need new things, new tools. And so we transformed the problem in such a way that, you know, the perturbation of the boundary stays in the unknown function u, because you have two unknowns. You have a perturbation of the boundary, which is h, and you have a solution that you want to find. So you have to find a domain and a solution. But once we did that, in fact, we had a serious trouble because we had the problem of loss of regularity. And of course, we tried to solve this problem for like 6 months, trying to use this Nash-Mosher implicit function theorem. But in fact, we luckily found a very, very tricky, very interesting argument that allowed us to solve the problem. So in the case of the two spheres, so we use this argument that we develop on the two cylinder in order also to develop the results on the two spheres. So in a sense here, so I put many bumps, but the idea is that, in fact, when you have this type of result in the cylinder, so you have something which is a band which is periodic. And so if you wanted to put it on a sphere, so you want to squeeze a little bit, so that you develop many, many bumps, and in this case, you can put them on this annulus on the sphere. So this is the recent result that I wanted to present. So my last slide. So I hope I didn't take too much time about this. Thank you very much.
Just want to ask the audience if there are any questions or comments.
Okay, I would like to congratulate Professor Moustapha Fall for his nice talk. And since he invited me to talk a little bit about shape optimization problem, and I am very glad to see that this is a very great result. The last one, you can find it in the archive. And I would like to ask you some question, because these two types of problem are, I'm thinking right now about these two types of conjecture, Pompeo and Schiffer problem. Here you have, there is a mu, a positive mu, such that you disprove the. Is it possible to do some characterization related to the eigenvalues problem here? And for the other question is, when you change, instead of taking the gradient, the absolute, the norm of gradient equals zero, you take a constant and you change for the boundary condition, the Dirichlet one, you put zero. And you authorize that mu may be an eigenvalue. What happened? Is it possible to go ahead with your outstanding idea you have developed in the last paper?
Yes. So you mean if I change the Dirichlet, then I put u is zero, and then the gradient of u is constant? Yes. In fact, we could, but there is a first result, I think, probably you know of Sigvaldi, right, in which maybe he's asking u to be positive. And so my PhD student, Inya, so he went to did the presentation in the experts of this in Granada, and they was asking him about this generalization. So with u can change the sign and things like that. And we were already able to do it. So we already write the draft, but we didn't find it too much now to publish it, because for now, because we already have this the which correspond to the Schiffer conjecture. So, yeah.
Yes.
Thank you, Moustapha, for the nice presentation, and congratulations for the prize, which is really honoring all of us from Senegal. So my question is, so I see that you use a lot, like, a metric, and you're like, you talk about geodesically complete and stuff like this. So are you just using a Euclidean metric, or would you be able to generalize some result, or is it interesting to talk about different Riemannian metric for these type of problems?
So here we just consider, for example, for the two spheres, the metric. The metric on the sphere. Uh-huh. So I didn't write maybe the G, or which
okay, so
says
I'm,
that it is the...
I'm saying maybe is it interesting to put like a different Riemannian metric on the space and study?
So we need also a lot of symmetries. So uh-huh. In a sense, okay. Yes, so yeah.
Okay.
But
okay.
Probably you can make, if you can maybe perturb maybe this metric. So you may have this result probably for a generic metric, I would say.
Mm.
A generic sense, but for the cylinder, it is really for the flat metric.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So.
Okay.
Yeah,
thank you.
What?
Thank you very much, Moustapha. I'm so happy. For you in your last paper, I was wondering if the assumption n equals 2 is a technical assumption in your opinion, or it's something more?
No, in fact, we could generalize it into any dimension. It's just we wanted to combine the two results because we first wrote the paper on the cylinder and later we met this conjecture of Swarm, and we could do it quickly and then we add it. But in higher dimension, you can do just that you need to ask axially symmetry, you know, in certain directions in order to resolve the problem. It's,
okay.
It's very
thanks.
Possible, thank you.
Yeah. Any other question? I think also not strictly mathematical. I mean, after all, the prize is also to point to a role model in various senses. So if our students want to ask, have some curiosities for, okay, well, so if not, I think I must speak here. Let's stay here with me.
Okay.
So we came to the end of this afternoon, and I'd like just to add my personal congratulations. I mean, I've been discussing mathematics with Professor Fall a few times. I managed to visit AIMS-Senegal once, and the hope is that this is, again, as often happens with prizes, that it's also a boost for to do more,
yeah.
and we are here also to discuss how and when. And I really want to thank all the authorities for being with us. I want to thank DST. I want to thank the International Mathematical Union with Professor Tilma and His Excellency the Ambassador of Senegal in Italy, and the Ambassador of India in Italy for having been with us today. Thanks a lot. I mean, the party continues on the terrace, I hope, I mean, people will be curious to get to know you a bit more personally
yeah.
outside.
Yeah.
So thanks to everybody, and see you next year.
Thank you.
No, the right one, the missing is important. This gets a bit too.